Call of Duty Warzone right now is the most played battle royale game, and everyone seems to have a lot of fun playing with this game. And it might be possible that you aren't getting the kills or the wins, but there are certain things that you can do to get better in Warzone. So here are 10 things that you can do to be better in Warzone. Number 10, turning off motion blur. Motion blur in various number of games are actually good, but sometimes in FPS game, it is not so good. And when you're playing it online, then motion blur doesn't help you in any way possible because it hampers your vision and the way you move. With motion blur turned off, you will have a better vision of what's happening, and it helps you to react faster and better, and just overall improves the way you play the game, as you can see whatever is happening around you. Plus, it actually makes the game look less horrible. Number 9, reducing FOV. FOV or field of view is very important in any online shooter games, and if your FOV is higher, then you will have a much better peripheral view of the game, but you will have a hard time focusing on the enemy that is right in front of you. If your FOV is lower, then you can focus and see the enemy clearly that is in front of you, and you can have a better shot at him and just a better accuracy while shooting. Of course, you cannot lower it all the way down, otherwise you will miss what's happening around you. So you need to balance it in a way that it works both ways. In my opinion, around 93 to 95 is the ideal FOV, which can help you notice the enemy in front of you much clearly, as well as look around the world in a much better way. This helps a lot in playing Warzone and getting those skills that your team really needs. Number 8, gliding as you drop. Now everyone knows that it is hard to go to longer distances when you're dropping down because it isn't like PUBG or Apex where you can glide to a longer distance, but good thing about this game is that you have unlimited parachutes, and what you can do is open your parachute and glide to a certain distance and then cut it again to get some momentum. And as your momentum increases, you can again deploy the parachute to have a faster and longer glide, and in this way you can go to longer distances if you want to. Now one more thing is that as you cut your parachute, you can kill someone who is in front of you gliding, since you can take your pistol out, and that's the most quickest way to kill someone even if they didn't touch the floor. But remember, the same can be done to you, which is even more frustrating, so just take a note of that. Number 7, sliding to your advantage. There are a certain number of things that you can take advantage of, and one of those things is sliding. If you combine your sliding with jump, you will be hopping around, and what this does is it makes you move faster and also harder for enemies to hit you. As you hit the button to slide, you can press the jump button immediately so that it gives you an extra hop that helps you to take out enemies if they are in some corner, because it would be harder for them to aim at you. Using this to move from one place to another is very vital in the end game, as the circle is very small, and if you're running through the gas, this will allow you to reach the circle in time. And trust me, doing this actually helps. Number 6, completing contracts. Now this game has included contracts that you can complete to get more money, and while there is one contract that tells you to kill certain someone, but there are certain other contracts that just lets you either stay in one place for a few seconds or go to certain locations to open different loot boxes. These contracts are called scavenger and recon, which will help you get more money, and with more money you can buy a lot of stuff for your team and yourself, and even revive your teammate if they are down. This helps in getting more money quickly, as it can be used for various different things from the shop. Number 5, loadout drops. Speaking of money, you can use them to buy loadout drops, which will allow you to use your own loadout in the game. Now if you don't have a loadout, you can always create one in the game menu by going to loadout option. Loadout helps you a lot because you will use your favorite weapon in the fight and have a better chance of winning. Even better is you call two loadout drops, where one of them will include an assault rifle and a sniper rifle, and you know how sniper is powerful in these games. And in the other loadout drop, you can have a loadout with Ghost as perk. Now with the help of Ghost perk, you won't be shown in the map when someone is using a UAV recon, and you can use that to your advantage, and in this way you also don't lose the weapon that you just got from the first loadout. Number 4, armor plates. Now with the shop, you can also buy armor plates for yourself and your team, and armors are very important because health in this game auto regenerates after some time. So if you have armor, you can be saved even if you have low health. So it's always better to have at least 3 additional armor plates at a minimum when you are playing this game. And the game also allows you to have 5 armor plates at maximum, even if you have loaded in 3 armor plates to your body. And at crucial moments, this will help you to load in more armor plates and get back into the fight to kill that team. If your teammates doesn't have enough money to buy armor, it is always better to give them some so that when the time comes, they will have your back. Number 3, vehicles are OP. Now what can I talk about vehicles in this game? They are just too powerful. Whether you are using a car or a truck or a helicopter, all of them can be very much used. You can use them to run over people and get easy kills, and the best way would be reversing a car or the truck so that the enemy doesn't have the time to kill you since he cannot see you exactly. Now you also have to keep one thing in mind is that people might have C4s or RPGs that can be used to completely destroy the vehicle, and with you being in it, you will be completely destroyed. The same goes for a helicopter, where you can use the blades to kill the people, and even better, if someone is dropping after being revived, you can use that chopper to kill them in mid-air. I mean, definitely, it is frustrating when that happens to you, but it is even more satisfying when you do it to someone else. Number 2, self-revive kit. Now in this game, you can revive yourself by either fighting in the gulag or someone spending money to respawn you, or you going to a cover hoping that your teammate will revive you in time. But you can actually buy a self-revive kit, which is much better than letting your teammates revive you, because in that way, your teammate will be very vulnerable to get hit by a certain someone. But with self-revive, that won't be the case. Another cool thing that you can do with self-revive is with team communication, you can use self-revive to a certain extent and then stop so that your friend can revive you without being stationary for a long time, as it instantly revives you. And you will also have that self-revive kit unused. So that helps you save that self-revive kit for a later time. And now coming to number 1, saving your killstreaks. Killstreaks in this game is very important as well, and people have innovative ideas on how to use it for their advantage, but to be honest, if possible, save that killstreak till the end of the game. I mean, I've seen people immediately use a killstreak the moment they get it. For example, precision airstrike, cluster strike, because they want to use it to kill someone, or they just want to see how the airstrike happens in the game, which is not the best option. And in the end game, when the circle is very, very small, you can use those airstrikes to get the most kills out of it. And maybe that can help you kill 2 squads at the same time, which will help you get closer to victory. Well, those are some of the things that you can do to get better at Warzone. I'm trying those myself, and I have to say, I have improved quite a lot. But obviously, if you have more tips that you want to share with us, you can let us know in the comments below of this very video. Thank you so much guys for watching this episode. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Make sure to hit that like button, click on subscribe and enable notification bell icon, because we got more videos coming very soon to this channel. Follow us on all social media platforms so that you can get to know everything about Gamer Connect. And also join Gamer Connect community on Facebook so that you can join in various activities, game discussions and so much more. And you can always find people to play Warzone with and make more friends.